rin.
Yung kasi yung nangyari. Totoo si naman eh. Anti-Mitch kasi literal focus eh.
Focus talaga. Ito naman yung, tira mo ngayon ang mga mukha ng Lupon ng execration. Nagulat sila doon kay Anti-Mitch.
Oo.
Pinag-uusapan natin to kanina eh. Diba, pinag-uusapan natin, match-up LJ, match-up ni Chakno, si Fersik. Mm-hmm. Pero si Anti-Mitch kasi, the main guy, the veteran, the MSC champion, binuwat yung ibos.
Actually, ang dami nga nating storyline, diba? Tank, support, although yung support nag-matter. Kasi yung kanina, talagang yung mas malaki yung impact nung Louie over the Estes, tapos yung gold team. Pero ang di natin in-expect is yung X-Play na magbabago tong ano na to. No? Kasi parang your stable eh. Parang there. Pillar ng dalawang team yung X-Play nila. Parang hindi mo ma-expect na may magbabago sa match. Yung sa dynamic na yun.
Totoo.
Pero nagpakita talaga si Anti-Mitch. And ito yung sinasabi natin kanina, they can actually switch up the XP role. Na parang minsan, gold lane yung gamit na hero ni Anti-Mitch.
Man, yung game, madi-describe mo na lang siya midnight sa sinasabi mo, Anti-Mitch.
Anti-Mitch, best of the best.
Best of the best. Ito, kailangan natin magbubuon sa game.
Oo.
Kailangan magbubuon din ng Exe. I feel na hindi rin, honestly, first time ko kasi nakita yung Exe sa ganong lineup eh.
Mm.
So I feel na kahit na siguro pinapractice nila yon, pagdating sa mga ganitong games, pagdating sa mga like run and gun, legit games, eh may onting galamay factor pa eh. May onting gamay factor. May onting ano pa sila, onting siguro experimental factor, yep, na hindi nila kabisado yung proper execution on playing that one. Yes, nare-rehearse nila pero again, bihira natin yun makita sa kanila.
Yeah, and looking at the bans, gusto ko yung tinanggal na ng execration yung Estes. Ibig sabihin, wala nang mag-uube this game. They're forcing a match na alam nilang laruin. Yung balagbagan gameplay, gusto nilang makita sa EVOS dahil alam nila, that alam ng execration, na pagdating sa balagbagan, again, team fighting ang expertise ng execration.
Yep,
gusto nilang dalin ang laban kung saan sila malakas.
Yeah, iniba na nila ang ihip ng hangin habang EVOS talagang intense itong intense tong ban nila, no?
Oh, talagang iniisip ko. Matilda. Tinggal na yung Matilda ni Chakno. Again, balik-pabalik tayo sa identity nitong dalawang teams na to, no? Siguro, wala na makakakuha ng Ube Strat. Wala na si Estes. Although, nag-exist pa si Rafaela. Pero mas lamang si Evos doon kasi sila yung nakakapag-Rafaela plus Brody.
Totoo. Men, wala na yung mga healing galing. May Rafaela pa. Meron akong theory.
Okay, ano yan? Theory of everything.
Faramis Bane.
Ay.
Pag eto nakalusot.
Ay, may Selena.
Pag eto nakalusot.
Eto Max.
Kuya Umi, Kuya Midnight. Pag eto nakalusot, hindi nag-research ang Ibus.
Napapailing na ako dito eh. Kasi naalala ko yun eh. Kasama ko ata si Batay Stone nung kinas namin ang Faramis Bane game na yon. Nabaliw ako noon dahil pinapunta ako first time sa Tagalog broadcast during the playoffs. I was expecting a very normal game, ha? Pero ito, execration, diba?
Get redemption after that second game, even hungrier now, knowing that I need to get this upper bracket position. I need to make MSSC 2021 basically the MPLPH Grand Finals.
You're absolutely on point there, Mirko. And Momo, any thoughts on this game, on this draft, perhaps?
Yeah, I really like EVOS Legion. They are just picking this Popo and Koopa.
Yeah.
And even Harriet, they didn't let Execration to play Harriet, especially Telra, even though he has to lose his Harriet just now, it's not exactly 100%. But yeah, better than you give it, you take a risk, right?
Yeah, you're right. Quad and Ling. Ooh, kill VJ. You're not only going to give the Yves away, you're going to let Ling get picked up by kill VJ. This is not a good it's not a good sign for EVO's Legends right now. Execration, this is their signature hero. Kill BJ on the sling. And obviously, we also have Kelra on the claw. Ball. This is looking so, so scary, guys. Execration. I might have to pick them now for a win.
Honestly, guys, this quad could be a boomerang for them because if EVO's Legends' composition is towards the early game and they could capitalize on that fact, this quad could not enter the late game.
Yep. Yes. EVO's Legends, they have to at least maybe secure one lockdown hero. EVO's Legends, they are taking that Aldous. What?
This is going to be the first Aldous picked by an Indonesian team. We have never seen this. Will it work? Because we haven't seen Fersik do this before.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Previously, when we saw this kind of matchup, Ling versus Aldous, the Aldous came up ahead on Blacklist versus Execration. This time around, it is a completely different game because there is no Estes and Rafaela to help this Aldous. So Aldous might just be bullied in the early game here, Gani.
That's the thing, right? I mean, so it all depends on Execration's approach here. Do they want to commit in the early game, or do they want to play it safe towards the mid-game, that late-game composition in their second drafting phase?
It's going to be Kufra, the next man coming from EVO's Legends towards this Execration.
Yeah, makes sense, it makes sense. They need a roamer, and Jawhead has been banned, Popo and Koopa has been picked up, so I think, and SS also has been banned, so I think banning another roamer will very, very limit the hero pools from the side of Chaknu.
It's kind of limited for Chaknu.
Exactly.
It is very limited right now, as EVO's Legends will ban that Kufra away. Perhaps a Grok ban will be incoming because the respect for Chak Mamba is just insane.
Yeah, he I still remember that Grok.
He is one of the main playmakers in the team. He has been the one being proactive on the map. He is the one looking for these crazy picks, and the other people usually follow up amazingly. But again, all that engage, if it's taken away, there will not be any follow-up as well, Gon.
That is very much true. And I think EVO's Legends could ban that Grok, or they could ban a sustainable hero frontliner in Barret, in Pakito, in Lapu Lapu, perhaps.
Yeah, you're right. And now Execration with their final ban. Oh, they are going to ban away.
Hylos
will ban Hylos. Okay.
Interesting. Interesting.
Have we seen Chaknu play Hylos?
No, the thing is, LJ has played Hylos. LJ is the one who played Hylos.
Yeah, exactly.
Hylos.
But have we seen in MPLPH Hylos being picked? I think
playoffs.
I think he has. He has.
In playoffs?
Yeah, I remember. Actually, yeah, I remember now. Chaknu has played this Hylos before in the MPLPH Grand Finals. And that might just be the respect here, because Execration, at this point, they don't really have a good engage hero. With the Kufra taken away, with the Hylos taken away, that's two very hard engage heroes gone.
Somehow forced to pick a Grok?
Somehow forced to pick a Grok, and maybe we can see an Atlas.
Oh!
It takes a lot of skill to play Atlas at this level, especially with the Purifiers coming in and against an Aldous, a guy who is super, super tanky. But it might work out if it is played properly, and the Forza ban will be the last for Execration. And now we look at the first pick of the second draft for EVO's Legends.
Yep, Execration, they play this Hylos when they're against Blacklist. And they kind of lose from Blacklist that time because the combination coming from Hylos, Lee, and also Angela didn't perform really well for Execration in the Grand Final.
You're right. And now EVO's Legends with their final. What do you think is going to be, Gandhi? What do you think is going to be Momochan?
I think Burst is good.
Burst is good. And for the side of Execration, they could actually pick up that
Angela. Oh, it's going to be Angela. Wow. Okay, EVO's Legends, they are just totally shut down Execration. They kind of limited.
You're right.
The Chaknu.
Exactly.
Yeah. Grok, probably.
It might just be the Grok here, but again, remember guys, we have seen the Estes Aldous. We have seen the Estes Rafaela Aldous. We have never seen an Angela Aldous.
Ooh. Okay.
Whoa, indeed. Because it's going to be very, very interesting to see how these two type of heroes, remember, Angela doesn't heal as much as Estes. He doesn't give a damage boost like Estes. He doesn't give movement speed like Rafaela. He gives a heart shield and some healing. Not a lot, some healing.
The utility is just to slow down opponents or immobilize them if if it's possible. Yep. You're right, and now Execration with their final pick. What will it be?
Oh, it's gonna be Akai and Chuck also Makito.
Mamba, all hail the Chuck Mamba Akai, because we've seen it before, Gani. Mm-hmm. It was amazing, dominating everyone with this
exactly.
Akai and the Makito on Renzio. No more glue. They are putting their tryhard pants on. It is the best Execration form versus the best EVOS Legends form. Wow.
What a series, guys.
What a series.
Game number one, game number two, and of course, this is going to be the climax of it all. Game number three. And for the last pick here, Momo-chan.
I just feel that this almost could be used by Anti-Mage. So yeah. Maybe EVOS, if they want to pick one marksman for first pick, it will be great. But this almost could be the jungle herself.
Okay.
It's gonna be Alice again. For Anti-Mage.
Oh, risky move here. Alice, Aldous, and as well as Karen.
It's Alice
it's
against
mid-game.
An Akai. Okay. Try to go in. Okay, that's one Execration. Momo-chan.
I really like Execration, though.
You like Execration as well?
Yeah, uh-huh.
Can you perhaps give us a reason?
I really like this Cloud in the hand of Terra and Link in the hand of Kills BJ as well. And we've seen
they got
the good. Yeah, we've seen a good Hurricane Dance coming from Akai. From Chaknu. So I would like to see Execration take the game number two.
You are absolutely right, but let's stop with the predictions. Let's get straight into game number three, the final match of a very intense series. Execration and EVOS Legends will go against each other for the final upper bracket position. Momo-chan.
Yes, Anti-Mage with this Alice, okay? Execration, they realized it was so scary from Anti-Mage, so they have to be careful. At least maybe they can try to give some pressure towards Anti-Mage's lane in the early.
Ooh, but look at this, already pressuring LJ, getting the better of KillVJ right now. KillVJ has to back away and the orange buff has been resetted here, and they will have to start it all over again. That is already a lot of time bought for
Fersic
in the jungle, and they are not stopping
they're coming back
for vengeance. Rexy goes in onto Chaknu, and it will be Chaknu taken very low. Remember, Chaknu is crazy on this hero, but Renzio goes onto LJ. Anti-Mage will be there to back him up. LJ has to flicker away, and that will just be no kills on the board, but a lot of time spent trying to get to KillVJ, and also for KillVJ, a lot of time wasted trying to get that orange buff, Momo.
Yep, but luckily no one actually being punished away from both of the teams. Yep, and still, EVOS Legion, they are playing so aggressively right now. Execration, they have a... I can say maybe they have a potential in the early game right now with this KillVJ for his Link, and also the E2 max with his Eve.
Yeah,
and even Lorenzo.
Okay, KillVJ will be able to retribution there, but now Rexy joins in. KillVJ forced to go away, but the Chase Fate has been popped onto KillVJ. He's actually going to go and stop it right there as he puts his focus onto E2 Max. Will not go more for that as Fersic will be able to dodge away. Chaknu still does not have a stun. He jumps in, but Renzio will not be able to follow up. KillVJ now joins in the fight. This is dangerous for EVOS, but they will choose to back away.
Yes, luckily KillVJ, he hasn't got his level 4 yet.
Yes.
So there's no Tempest of Blade from KillVJ. EVOS Legion, they are still able to survive.
Yeah, but look at this. They are already trading Momo-chan. They're not just giving this turtle for free. They're already getting the
look
turret
the
gold down
damage.
There. And Renzio will be able to dash in, flicker, and get first blood. Renzio and Execration strikes first blood here in game number three.
Yep, got the double advantage, I can say, from Execration right now. Renzio with this Makito put a lot of damage as well towards that LG just now.
Yeah, you're right. And Fersic still stacking as usual. Ling also getting a very good start right here after that invade.
But still, they have to be careful with this Anti-Mage.
Yes.
Yes.
Very, very scary from Anti-Mage right here.
Just don't give him a lot of space to just...
Not just that, not just Anti-Mage,
the item,
but also that...
Clover.
Yeah, Clover. Also Clover on that Harith.
Personally, I think Execration needs to realize that they are a little bit somehow stronger in the early game, and they need to maximize on it.
Yep, that's true. But now look at EVOS Legion, Anti-Mage, now they are trying to make some rotation. I think he's ready for the team fight though.
Yeah, he is ready for the team fight, trying to do some damage, trying to deal some damage onto KillVG, but
oh,
unfortunately KillVG is not there now. Fairsick, Hurricane Dance to Fairsick. Fairsick trying Tempest to play away, but there is a lot of damage right there. Fairsick will just be taken
max?
Down instantly. Clover will be next. It is a disaster for EVOS Legends, but no, they actually get away. It will just be a 1-for-0 trade for Execration Momochan, but now his Mount Force has been bothered.
Oh.
KillVG, kill picked up 1-for-1 again as they will be able to secure the purple buff. Wow. What a close game.
Yeah, that's really a good threat coming from Clover with the Zalmarn Force comes in. They know that actually, EVOS Legend, they have to trade it with something.
Yeah, you're right. They have to trade with something. And right now, Aldous is still trying to get that lead. Obviously, right now, it looks like KillVG was able to secure one buff faster than Aldous. As now, he puts his focus onto the purple buff. After the purple buff, mm-hmm. he should have a gold and XP lead over KillVG.
Yes, and KillVG needs to be careful because he doesn't have that purple buff. He cannot just spend any energy, just maybe willy-nilly here from KillVG.
Yeah.
EVOS Legend, now they are looking to find someone else. They are trying to make a rotation right now.
Second turtle.
Just keep giving a lot of space and also time for Clover and also Alice to just scale their item.
You're right, but the second turtle will be uncontested by the side of Execration. EVOS Legends, they choose to get some pressure on that top side, getting the turret gold instead of competing for this turtle, Momochan.
Yes, and keep doing the same thing from Antimates right now. He just, you know, I just cut the lane, okay? I just keep cutting the lane here. And Clover, Kelra comes in with Zalmarn
Clover. Mm-hmm. Ooh, almost gets a kill, and that will be the hard guard helping him up. But again, very nice by Kelra. Yeah, very nice by Kelra, baiting three members onto that top side while Anti-Mage will be forced to dome to. Oh, what? He actually goes in onto four members. This might be a mistake for Anti-Mage. It will be the Hurricane Bands. But again, buying a lot of time, and the flicker was used by Chakai.
Chakai?
You like that? Chakai.
Chaknuakai.
Chaknuakai.
Okay.
Yes, that's what the Filipinos call him.
Okay, but Rangio comes
again
with the heavy left hand and also
very
the jab.
Aggressive.
But it's gonna be a little more manipulation pop up by E2Max right now.
LJ!
No one can actually try to cover LJ here. Clover still run away with the Zalmarn Force. The Tempest
Ooh.
Of Flipping used. KillVG is trying to find someone, but Clover is just too strong.
Yeah, and remember, Anti-Mage, he didn't join the fight, so a 1-for-1 trade will be in favor of EVOS Legends as they will be able to get the turret in the bottom side as well. Gani, any thoughts to this?
I think right now, EVOS Legends are controlling the map. They are actually having the more, they have more space than mm-hmm. Execration. And as for the items, guys, I mean, Ling is building immediately towards that DHS. Meanwhile, for the side of Aldous, he is, again, building that defense item here, guys.
Maybe
probably
Athena
brute
suit?
Force. Brute force, perhaps.
Oh, the brute force.
Or even that thunder belt.
Yeah,
thunder belt.
We'll actually take that purple buff and look at EVOS Legends' positioning, though. They're already waiting for two members right now. Chaknu
yep.
will be able to go into that
Uh-oh.
Bush, but they're gonna go onto E2Max. The Mount Force has been popping with E2Max taken down, and now
God.
Clover goes onto Kelra. Kelra taken very low. Clover still trying to do something.
Ooh,
it's Rexy. Flickers over the wall for a kill, but it will be Rexy taken very low. Taken down. Wow. Even in that moment, Kelra still gets a kill.
Yeah, meanwhile, Fersik in the mid lane trying to shut down KillVG. No, because Chaknu will just try to cover his teammate here. It's gonna be 1-4-2 in the hand of EVOS Legend. Now, EVOS Legend, they are looking. Oh, look at that.
Clover,
this guy, he just doesn't want to stop. He just keep doing the same thing over and over again. Look at that. E2Max trying to stop him.
Chaknu?
The real world manipulation. Chaknu,
the Chakai Hurricane Dance comes in, but the hard guard
and
is
purify.
There.
And the
My
Purify.
My God, and the beautiful Purify. Yes, Momochan.
That's really a good Purify coming from that Clover.
And Anti-Mage again zoning away, trying to take this purple buff, getting turrets all across the board.
Uh-huh.
Wow.
Same condition in the same, I can say maybe in the first game right now, EVOS Legend, they are dominating in the last game of our upper bracket.
Exactly, things are not looking good, but as I said that DHS has been secured
mm-hmm.
by KillVG, so
yep.
I think in the next 2 minutes or so, Execration are looking for a
Look how
team
rich
fight.
Clover.
Whoa, this guy is a candidate for the rich guy position right now. It's 5,595 gold on top of Fairsick and on top of Kelra.
Yeah, Execration, they have to give some time for Kelra to scaling his item. Because it's really hard. Look at this already.
Gonna use that. Actually, Hurricane Dance is thrown away. Rexy's gonna be the target right now. The Blaze Duet will be able to get that. As Clover goes to E2 Max. It will be the chase fade onto E2 Max. E2 Max gonna be bursted away by E2, by Clover and Ferrisic. They look towards Renzio right now. The dashes come in. Ferrisic goes in. And Anti-Mage is there for the follow-up. He tries to go back in. It will be the immobility coming in to pick the kill up. It is still EVOS Legends on the victory push. Kill BJ gets taken down. It is now a 3-for-2 trade.
This is what I said, okay? It's hard to play Cloud if you don't have enough stock and if you don't have enough item as well. And look at that, Chaknu trying to push him away. Hurricane Dance first stick. But Ferrisic still able to run away. Look at the stun that he had.
Ferrisic still able to run away. And no, my God. Clover goes in. Whoa. EVOS are roaring right now.
Oh, my God. Execration. What is happening?
Slight miscommunication there, I think, perhaps. And miscalculation as well. Clover is just right on time, right on cue to help out his teammates right then and there.
You're right, and now EVOS Legends with a 4,000 gold lead with 5 turrets to 0. Already super ahead, but Execration, they still have that late game insurance in that Claude Gonyi.
Look at this!
This is exactly what I said! If EVOS gets too comfortable, they get the picks on the game, and Execration find a good pick onto Rexy. This is the main thing that's going to happen. This is the main conflict that's going to happen. EVOS, they are a particularly early game team. Execration, they like bringing out the team fights. They like to just go in like this. And this is where it shows. Which team will be the best? Adversity. Battling through this.
Oh, you're absolutely right there, Mirko. And we can see, I mean, Kelra is already fed up, I guess. With Claude, with the HS, with also that Golden Staff. I'm thinking that he wants to team fight. But then again, EVOS, they have a good, strong lineup to cover, and as well, front-to-back lineup, basically.
Yeah, Naldus is split pushing the top side more.
Look at that. EVOS, they are trying to secure another objective right now. They are trying to bait a member from Execration to just contest this Lord.
Yeah, you're right. And now, remember, the chase fade has been used all the way there. Ferrisic will actually join the fight. Now Renzio goes into the fight, but he gets bursted down. It will be Clover picking up the kill.
Rexy,
Anti-Mage in the middle of everything, goes into E2 Max, and that is Clover taken down. Kill BJ gets a kill. Anti-Mage getting outplayed, but he will not. He will flicker inside to get the kill. Ferrisic looking for kill. BJ will not be able to get Chaknu. Kelra still dashing away, but Kelra gets taken low. LJ trying to look for the kill. Ferrisic will trade and go for Kelra taken down, and Anti-Mage will get that kill as well. Ferrisic chasing Chakai right now as he tries to run away, but there is nowhere to go. It will just be Ferrisic taking the kill once he catches up.
Look at that in the middle lane.
Yeah, Chakai is hella fast right now, but the Lord has spawned in the mid lane. Chakai still running away, but it will be most probably the turret taken down here by EVOS Legends.
Yes, and now Execration looking finally got shot down just now, and Renzio trying so hard to defend their base. Execration, you have to be careful because they don't have any.
Renzio goes in for the double knockout, and this is the outplay! This Execration goes for more! Ferrisic gets taken low, Rexy and Clover, there's nothing they can do. LJ goes to the backside to disturb him, but he gets taken down. Is this the throw from Clover? Is this the throw from EVOS? Clover goes back in, he gets some damage in. Kill BJ looking for a jump, but there is no one, as Ferrisic is too tanky, will be able to get the inhibitor turret. Now Chakai looking for an engage, but oh my god, Execration, even with all the turrets being taken down, still putting up a fight, guys.
Yeah, they are still able to defend their base in just 1-for-1 trade just now. Execration, they are still look very strong.
Wow, and wow, Gani. This is a beautiful game from both teams. They're playing it as best as they can with the drafts that they are given by their coaches. For now, let's take a look at the lead. Let's take a look at the winning conditions for both teams, Gani. Let's start with Execration.
Execration needs to force target. Wait a minute, guys.
Look at that.
It's still super tanky. He's still actually buying a lot of time, but it will be Kelra getting killed. It will be Anti-Mage as well. Three members for one. This is where Execration makes their comeback.
Wow. Same condition in the first game just now. Now Execration, they are moving so fast.
They are moving too fast, but unfortunately for them, The Lord still spawns in 90 seconds, but they will take what they can get here, probably invading jungles and as well as pushing lanes.
What a play from our Philippines team, okay? They lose their 3 inhibitor turret and now Execration, they're still able to just keep giving a pressure towards EVOS Legion, who actually is so much upper hand right now.
Yeah,
all the objective.
It was a 4,000 gold lead, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it was a 6,000
gold
lead here, but
jab.
Execration keeps on finding plays, as this is the replay brought to you by Opogon.
Exactly. Well, in this particular case, EVOS were too offside there, and Yves got that real-world manipulation on point there.
I got deja vu, actually. It's the same.
Oh, but what? Kill DJ gets taken very low. Look at that. He's running. He's almost one bar.
Yeah.
Bro.
It's only the chase fate being popped up by Persic.
2k worth of gold lead, guys.
Yeah.
2k worth of gold lead.
It's only 2k. Now Execration is slowly but sure they are trying to catch up from all of the loose.
You're right, and now EVOS Legends, they are already pushing onto every single lane. Alda split pushing here, and let's take a look at the player head-to-head while we have this moment of peace for a second.
Well,
tell me about this team.
Exactly, well, Persic got 3 MVPs. Meanwhile, Execration, they are more of a team comp. Kill VJ and Killra has the most MVPs on that team.
Yep, Kill VJ now.
Yeah.
Execration, they just need to, you know, maybe execute it pretty properly, okay?
Yeah. All
right, but Anti-Mage goes in, actually goes on to kill VJ. Oh, he flickers inside! Killra is in a target! He's in place, the wet. Clover dashing in, trying to get some kills, but he gets bursted down.
Winter
it is Anti-Mage zoning everyone. Winter Truncheon being used
kill
as
VJ.
Kill VJ gets killed on the other side of the map. Anti-Mage now
Fancy
goes in onto 3 members.
Ooh,
he gets one! Immortality being popped! Now he is alone! The Winter Truncheon! The clutch! Winter Truncheon! But it is Execration getting the better trade, guys! 2-for-1. Execration as the Lord comes back up.
Yeah, they still have a strong high ground, I can say, with this blessing duet coming from Cloud and even that Chakno. Did you guys see the hurricane is coming from
Beautiful
Chakno?
Chakai.
Yep.
Beautiful.
When Anti-Mage jump in with the flying blood and also the blood, Chakno just straight away used that hurricane dance to just clear all the way.
He stole the little wanderer. Chakai is doing wonders right here.
Chakai is just doing what he has to do.
Oh, this is Execration building a risky play here.
Wow.
Oh, but remember, EVOS Legends, they're not going to go without a fight. I don't think they should contest this right now. It will be the real revelation using to the backside. Chakno trying to deal some damage. No, Clover trying to deal some damage on the Chakno. Zaman Force has been used. It will be Chakno taken down. Now, Persic goes to the backside. Killra gets taken low. That's going to be the hard guard as well to the backside. He's looking for more, but he won't be able to get it. Kill VJ still running around, getting his escape as they have gotten the Lord 1-for-1, guys.
Yep, now look at that. Lord is already marching down into the top lane. Now, EVOS Legends, they have to shut down this Lord in the first place. Or maybe Kill VJ, he just can use a lot of time to just doing some split push here, but no.
Ooh. I got chills, guys. I got chills.
I got goosebumps, actually.
I got goosebumps, but now the Eldest will try and go and 1v1 this Lord right now, but he has to be careful. There
Kill
is
VJ.
A lot of pressure from Execration as they have all the lanes pushing up.
Execration, they have to pay attention into this minimap here. The Super Minion just keep going and going.
Oh, Feather of Heaven will be completed by Anti-Mage Garni.
Exactly, and well, looking at the turrets here, EVOS Legends with 9, basically all turrets from Execration has gone down, but the gold lead is just, actually Execration has the gold lead here.
Yeah, a 400, 500 gold lead now.
A slight lead.
A very slight lead, but remember, in the late game where everyone has full items, they don't really have a lot that they can take or have a lot of lead because the items are already completed. The XP levels are all leveled up. Now look at
Persic.
The Hurricane Dance going Persic away. Chakno now trying to do something, but Anti-Mage!
Oh
my god! He goes into 4 members! He finds something and it will be E2 Max taken down. Winter Truncheon still there, but
oh my god!
It will be a trade-off. Anti-Mage for Killra. The gold laner for the XP laner as EVOS Legends did not follow up that play.
And even E2 Max still able to survive with only 1 HP. Luckily that he has the Winter Truncheon. EVOS Legion now, they are still survive. They are struggling, I can say.
Yeah, you're absolutely right here.
Execration did a good job just now.
Yeah, very good job.
With
Kill VJ, he might just be caught out here. Ferrisic goes in, Rexy goes
on
a flicker, and the chase fate follows him up. It will be Killra taken down! And now it looks like EVOS have finally done it. That is the jungler down.
Ooh.
They're looking for more fights on the game, and EVOS will keep on looking for these picks. LJ checking every single bushes. And the purple buff will actually be secured by Clover here.
Yep. It's gonna be an advantage as well for EVOS Legion because this Ling won't have enough time as well to get another purple buff.
You're right, and now Execration trying to defend in 20 seconds still, so Execration can still defend this. It will probably go to the last Lord. Whoever get that that last and final Lord, it will be the game changer for them.
True, and very much true. Well, then again, the winning condition from the side of Execration, they need to take down Clover or, I don't know, somehow Fursic.
Anti-Mage
is hard.
Stop this guy, okay?
Yeah, and Anti-Mage could die last. They need to find pickoffs towards Clover or Fursic first.
And exactly, Anti-Mage, he just wants to shut down E2Max at the backline. Yeah. He doesn't care about anyone.
That's
else.
The thing. They know the winning condition is target that E2Max or Kilra first. And that's why that is the way to go for the side of EVOS Legends.
And guys, it is 40 seconds to this Lord, and they are just completely getting pressure on the map, going back to the bushes there. They are not trying to risk anything right now, as the traps have been placed as well by Rexy. Anti-Mage will try to open up the map as well with that flowing blood, but this is just the battle for the final position, and all the gold does not matter at this point. Everyone is at full items.
Yeah. It's gonna be depends on the execution from both of the teams, and I think it's kind of difficult for Execration, especially the super minion just keep coming into the tree lane of Execration right now. They have to maybe pay attention into the minion.
Oh, and Rexy actually gets a little bit of chunk damage to Chakru, gets a good trap as well, as now he's putting his pressure on this purple buff with the help of Fursic, trying to secure it away from Ling, as this Lord, this Ling is not... Can't do really anything, not a lot of things without the purple buff, but it will be Ling taking it away. And now KillVJ has the purple buff, has the pressure, will have the orange buff as well, as EVOS Legends are looking for the Lord, guys.
Yep, look at that Execration. They know they cannot lose this Lord, okay? They have to contest it. No matter what happened, they have to try it.
You're right, they cannot lose this. They cannot lose this Lord because this will most likely be the final Lord. Anti-Mage is still tying there, and Chaknu actually gets bursted down very low. They might just look for this, but Chaknu will just go away. And remember, guys, if this goes down, it will not be anything here as Clover. Fursic baiting all the abilities. Again, they're just baiting. They're trying to get the abilities, and now they're looking for the re-engage. Fursic joins in, tries to chase Kilra down. One hit, two hits. Kilra almost gets taken down, and E2Max forced to flicker away. They will start this Lord up for the second time.
Yep, now EVOS, they are looking to take down the Lord. Meanwhile, the Execration, they are trying so hard
Chakai,
to defend.
If he can steal this, he truly is the god. But no, he doesn't. It will be the Lord taken away by Harry.
No, Chakru
actually fails to dash. Yeah, he failed to jump. That was gave me a heart attack.
It gave me a heart attack as well. Wow, this Chakai.
This Chakai is doing wonders for his team, but right there, unfortunately, he's not a jungler. He doesn't have retribution. He cannot steal that Lord. I was hoping for a steal there, as that would be a highlight play.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, it's very unrealistic to think so.
It's kind of hard, okay? For
Akai, extremely hard. But,
oh my god, now EVOS Legion, look at that. The Lord is crumbling, and even though looking to finish the game for EVOS Legion, but Execration, they still have a strong high ground.
Right, and now Real World Manipulation has been popped to zone them away, so this will be one of their teamfight utilities used, one of their teamfight tools used away to come here. Now Clover dashes in with Zaman Force, getting damage onto KillVJ's. Anti-Mage joins in the fight. Kilra will be able to use the laser well on the backside, but Winter Function is still there. Now Fursic trying to do damage. The Hurricane Dance does not connect as Clover uses the Purify. They're looking for the base. Fursic is targeting him. Anti-Mage trying to get this. EVOS Legends, they're just focusing the base. And my god! EVOS takes the game 2-1. Ladies and gentlemen,
what a play for Indonesian team, EVOS Legion, Execration.